On today's Visual Studio Toolbox, Leslie shows us five cool ways to personalize Visual Studio. Hi, welcome to Visual Studio Toolbox. I'm your host, Robert Green, and joining me today is the regular host of the show, Leslie Richardson. Hi, Leslie.
Hi, I'm so excited to be on the show. Wow.
I'm so excited to have you on the show as a guest.
Wow, I don't think I've ever been on the show before. This is exciting.
So rather than just have you do the hosting and the guesting and asking yourself questions, we're going to be on the show together. That's awesome. And you're going to show us five ways to personalize Visual Studio.
Yeah. Yep. I've got some hot tips just based off of things that I use regularly in Visual Studio and also things that I recently discovered that I thought were really cool and were worth showing off. So
yeah, I think it's really easy to just accept the Visual Studio defaults and never really notice them. But there's so many things you can do to personalize it. So I'm excited to see these.
Yeah, and these are super random. My only thing is we're actually not talking about themes today because I thought that would be too obvious. But if you haven't used Visual Studio themes, definitely check it out because there's a lot of cool options on the marketplace. But cool. So shall we dive on in?
Let's do it.
Awesome. So I'm going to share my screen. Cool. So tip number one, solution colors. So this is an extension actually that good old Mads Christensen made pretty recently. And it's actually part of a larger experiment to see if this may someday get incorporated into Visual Studio as an integrated feature. But I think it's really nice, especially if you have multiple monitors or multiple instances of Visual Studio specifically that you're hopping between that each contain different solutions. So if you're like me, there have been times where it's 2 a.m. Like I remember I was creating a demo for Ignite last year, and I was going through between two similarly named solutions, and I edited one, having not realized that I edited the wrong one. So, you know, I'm trying to debug my code, wondering why haven't my changes appeared in the right solution? And it turns out, oh, I just wasn't paying attention to the correct instance. So as a way to help you out with that, solution colors can come into play. This is very similar to color tabs if you've used those. So you can right click on a solution and then set solution color and choose a color of your choice. I'm gonna go with gold. And I also have another instance open to show it off. And for this other solution that I've got, right click and set solution color. Pick a color.
Oh, let's go mint.
All right, I like mint. Sweet. And what I like as a bonus is when you hover over your window toolbar, you get you get little quick indicators that don't involve having to read at 2 a.m. telling you what goes with what and swapping between them. So it's just another easy identifier when you're hopping between multiple instances of Visual Studio.
So it primarily shows in that line at the bottom and then, okay. Oh, that's awesome.
It's pretty sick. I just discovered this. Thank you, Mads.
What I do a lot is I rewrite a lot of my demo apps. So I have a Xamarin Forms app and I'm going to rewrite it in MAUI. And all of the names are the same because the code just copies and pastes over. And then I'm constantly confused which one it is. They're both open in Visual Studio. They're both named the same.
Yep. Yeah.
That would be cool.
Lifesaver. So if you want to try that out, it is an extension. It's called Solution Colors, I believe. I think I have it up here somewhere.
Solution Colors.
There it is. Yep. That's the one you want. It's
cool. By Mads.
Thank you, Mads.
Excellent.
Cool. So tip number two, I'm cheating a bit because it's kind of multiple tips in one, but there's so many ways to customize tabs now. It's ridiculous. Mm-hmm. So I already mentioned color tabs. So if you want to do that, let's use this example. Color tabs, you can go into tools, options, and you have a whole section for tabs and windows and a lot of different ways to customize from here. So if you check the colorize document tabs by option, and then you can choose how you want your tabs to be colored, either by project or file extension. I'm gonna stick with project. In this example, I have like 20 some projects within this solution. So as you can see, I've got multiple colors, just a really nice indicator. Again, especially if you're like me and you've named a lot of your files the same thing, it can be a nice way to be able to quickly identify what goes with.
I use that a lot. I have the XAML, the .XAML file, one color, and the .XAML.cs file, a different color, because I have them all in the tab. The XAML files are all on top. The .CSs are all on the bottom because, you know, they all have the same first name. So yeah, I use that a lot to separate those types.
Awesome. Yep. And that's exactly what it's for.
Yep.
So shout out to Grace and her team. Grace is on the show pretty recently. They put in color tabs a couple updates ago. I don't know, maybe over a year ago. Time flies. So really cool.
Cool.
Also really cool are the different ways that you can lay out your tabs. So we've got horizontal tabs by default, but you can also organize them by vertical. So if I wanted to place the tabs on the left, then I could do that. And also if you have color tabs enabled, it's great because it splits them all up for you too.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm. But I prefer to keep things horizontal, so I'm going to set mine back to horizontal. And what's even better than the horizontal layout now is that in the most recent Visual Studio update, I think, so 17.3, I want to say, you can have your tabs in multiple rows. How sweet is that? So you don't have to have your hidden tabs hidden away. If you want to see everything all at once, then you can do that.
Cool.
So the possibilities are endless. And I'm going to swap back to what I had before. So tip number three, also kind of related to tabs, but if you've ever had that issue of having multiple tabs open and you're choosing the default tab layout, it can sometimes be difficult to tell which of these open tabs is currently being displayed on screen right now and which one is. Yeah. So now there's a new feature that was also introduced in a recent update called showing names not visible in italics. So you'll notice that some of these are italicized, and these are the tabs that are currently off screen. So if I wanted to open that, then I can do that. I love this thing to death. If you want to enable it because it's not set by default, you can go into tools options back in the tabs and windows section. And, it is here somewhere. Oh, the show invisible tabs in italic and tab dropdown menu. That's the one you want.
Cool.
Sweet. So tip number four, we have got rainbow braces. So, you know, sometimes when you're going through your code, it can be a little frustrating trying to quickly identify which bracket lines up with which bracket or which brace lines up with which brace sometimes, especially if you have like maybe a nested situation going on.
Isn't that what the dashed lines are for, though?
That is what the dashed lines are for to some degree. But let's say you have the braces, like the parentheses, that don't do that. Okay. And if sometimes you might have like a nested function call or something like that, something that makes it a little harder to tell what brace goes with which unless you move your cursor directly in that section. So if you just want to quickly skim through and make sure you're on the right track, there is another extension that you can check out called Rainbow Braces, which was also created by Mads. Thank you, Mads. And there's an equivalent extension that's been in the marketplace for a while that does a similar thing called Diaspora, if that's how you pronounce it. But I can just use my keyboard shortcut, Shift-Control-9. And you'll notice that all of my braces and parentheses have been colored for me. So it gives me like a quick identifier to know what's going with what without having to constantly move my cursor to the place in order to get it highlighted by default.
Oh, cool.
Yep. So I like this one a lot. you know, those times where you might forget a brace and yes, you get the error message, but sometimes it's just nice to be able to cleanly tell.
Yeah, it actually gives you a nice set of glance. It gives you more information than the dashed lines.
Yeah.
I like that.
Totally. And last but not least, the fifth tip that I've got for you is custom window layouts. I just found out about this like a couple of days ago. Didn't even know it existed, but I think it's been around for a while. That's usually how a lot of Visual Studio features go. when it comes to discovery sometimes. But this lets you save your layout of your IDE and then load it back up when you feel like it. So to use it, we're going to go into window and save window layout. So I'm going to keep what I have here. And let's call this one the norm.
Mm-hmm.
And so while this doesn't work for everything, it works great for when you want to customize which windows are currently docked or where they're positioned, if you don't want certain windows displayed, that sort of thing. So let's say I don't want the package manager console. I'm going to close this out. And I'm going to move the solution explorer to the left-hand side, which I feel like I should have anyway. I'm left-handed, and I find it a lot more intuitive to keep the solution explorer to the left-hand side of the screen.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. So then we're going to go into window, and I'm going to save this window layout, and I'm going to call it the new norm. We're very inspired with names here on the Visual Studio team. And so then from there, you can go load up your saved window. So you go into apply window layout. What's great is you also have keyboard shortcuts. So I'm currently on the norm. The new norm. We can go back to the norm. And there it is.
And does that save your open documents as well?
It does not, from what I understand, it does not apply to your Windows documents that are currently open and stuff like that. So
that could be a nice enhancement, because then if you were done for the day and you were shutting down Visual Studio, but you wanted to open up next time, literally where you were with all the files open, potentially even scroll down to the same place.
Yeah.
That might be interesting.
Mm-hmm. So it's pretty nice. And you can also like choose to have one view where the window is split. Mm-hmm. So like, looking at multiple tabs at the same time, you can do that.
Yeah.
And
yeah, I think a lot of people have their home multi-monitor view and then their laptop on the road view, or different views for different project types.
Yeah. I just think it's really cool because honestly, this is something that I wanted to see in VS for a while. Like, I think this version could still use some work, and I'll probably be going over to the dev community and putting in my own feature suggestions as to how to expand this idea. But just having the ability to provide custom experiences that you can toggle between is very similar to, I use Photoshop a lot. So they have like by default custom workspaces, like here's the photography workspace or the graphic design workspace. And then depending on which one you click, it gives you the related tools and stuff front and center and hides away the ones that you may not necessarily need for that particular topic. So would love to see this feature utilized a lot more in the future.
Yeah, cool. So let's review. We did five ways. What were they?
Yes. So we had solution colors. Great. If you have multiple instances of VS and you need to differentiate between them, especially if they're multiple solutions. We talked a lot about tabs. So we've got vertical tabs, colored tabs, being able to show tabs in multiple rows. Number three, we had being able to show your hidden tabs in italics. We also have number four, which is rainbow braces, the ability to quickly identify what brace or which parenthesis is going with what. And you can use, this one requires an extension, much like solution colors. It's called rainbow braces on the Visual Studio Marketplace. Definitely check it out. And number five, we talked about custom window layouts.
Awesome. Very, very cool.
Sweet. Yeah. I think it's pretty cool. You discover something every day, even though you work on the product every day.
Yeah. Some of these things obviously will have been in the product for longer. Some are brand new extensions. So there's so much going on.
Yep.
That is cool. Well, thanks for coming on the show and thanks for letting me host the show. To have you come on.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Maybe I can come back sometime.
Maybe.
I don't know.
We'll work on a five more ways to personalize Visual Studio episode.
Awesome.
Awesome. All right. Hope you guys enjoyed that. We will see you next time on Visual Studio Toolbox.